Brett Olson, the captain, was our number one star last night. Of course, he has a lot of fans, family in the building. Being from Superior, this is like a home game to him in many ways, or a coming home game, and this will be likely his, you know, this will be his last regular season game in Duluth as a college hockey player. We talked a little bit about last night's game and what exactly went on during the first intermission after trailing 4-0.
Yeah, well, we just kind of got together in the locker room after Coach came in and gave us an honest breakdown of that period, and we knew it ourselves, so we weren't happy with the way that we played, and we wanted to make sure that we at least played for a little bit of pride on our jersey, for the name on the front of our jersey as well. And, you can't just give up in that situation. We, picked our chins up off the floor and knew we had two periods left. And all we knew is we had to do and play as best as we could out there. And fortunately, we were able to make some good plays and start skating and working to earn the good things that happened.
Did you feel if we got one in that second period, we had a chance?
Yeah, I mean, we talked about it before. We've been in that situation, not maybe so much as it was as a four-goal deficit, but at that point we knew that, just plugging away one at a time, you're not going to get all four at once, and it was going to take a concerted effort from everybody, and everybody had to stick together and stick to our game plan. We kind of got away from that. We didn't play too much, too well in the neutral zone. We didn't play too well defensively, and then when we were getting pucks in the offensive zone, we weren't making smart decisions, so... a lot of it was probably more mental, and then when you're not there mentally, you're not going to be moving physically. So you got to get both those things together, and then once we did it, it was a good thing for us.
But not only have to score for, to possibly tie, but you have to shut them down for two periods and an overtime too.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, if you can play good defense first, good things offensively are going to happen. But if you're going to be the aggressor and take it upon yourself to make plays, it's up to them to try to stop you. And we kind of reversed the roles there last night after the second.
He had two assists that helped out big time in that third period to tie the game. Which one are you most proud of? Because both of them were pretty impressive. I like the one where you were coming down the slot and dished it off.
Oh, they're just plays where you got to make plays at certain times, and if you have the opportunity where you have lanes and stuff, you can't miss them. It's just can't say I'm more proud of one than the other. But that's what I expect of myself, to be completely honest with you, is making plays and. The fact of the matter that we were able to put them in the back of the net with Jordan and Sony there on both there, it was a great, great feeling.
Obviously, this could be the last time you play here, which is so close to your home, and a lot of family and friends in the building here again tonight. Is this a special night for you?
Yeah, it is. It's always a special night when I come back. It is basically a hometown game for myself, and the family's been great over the last 4 years, and there's going to be a bunch of black and gold up in the stands supporting us as well as friends, too. There's a bunch of community members from Superior that... are either season ticket holders here and aren't sure who to cheer for tonight, or they're just coming over to watch the game. So, just trying to go out there and not do anything too different. And I don't want to get too excited. Don't want to get too high or too low, but just make sure I'm playing my game and take care of itself, and then we'll be able to just see everybody for a little bit after, which will be nice.
Are you confident we'll have a better start tonight?
Absolutely. There's no doubt we can't afford one. That's not a good start, and I think the guys understand that, especially after having the eye-opener that it was last night. But we have to make sure that we not only start well, but continue to carry the momentum and not stop, because we saw what happened on the opposite side last night.
And we talked to Coach Pearson, first of all, about the period intermission and what exactly he talked to the team about to get the turnaround in that second period.
Yeah, breakout. We're having real difficulty getting the puck out, and we decided just to flood one side of the rink and just sort of chip the puck. We didn't have opportunities to make too many direct passes, so... you could say that's more offensive because we have the puck, but it's really defensive. We just had to get out of our zone and get in some foot races. So I thought we did a good job of that, and we look to continue some of that tonight.
Jacob Johnstone had a big goal for us. It was really nice to see him kind of get going, and really had some other opportunities, too, that he hasn't been getting a whole lot of.
No, he had a good game. He's a very good hockey player, and, from time to time as a player, you go in a little bit of a drought where maybe things aren't going your way or you're not picking up the points, but... he's continued to work hard, and he's got tremendous talent, and good for him last night. So hopefully that'll be a real boost to his confidence.
The Milos, Tanner Carroll, and Ryan Fernline seemed to also get more offensive opportunities once that first period was over with.
Well, I think our whole team did. We got put on our heels. We took a penalty early, and obviously then they scored, and bang, bang. And we just didn't have time to regroup, seemed like, from that. But you're right. The second and third period, that's how we need to play, and we need to play consistently like that on a nightly basis, wherever we're playing, whoever we're playing. And when we do that, we're going to have a lot of success.
Was it tough for you to keep Josh in there after that first period, or was it a pretty easy decision? Obviously the right one.
Well, I think it was an easy decision. You know, I didn't even ask Steve Shields or the coaches about it. My whole thing is the goals. You know, if they're stoppable or weak goals, you might, you know, maybe think about pulling them. But, you know, it's good for him to have to battle through that. You know, we all deal with adversity, and, you know, he's dealt with a little adversity in the first period being a goalie, and, you know, it's good for him to battle back. But the goals, he really didn't have any chance, I didn't think, on any of the four goals, and I just wanted to see if he could battle back. And it just wasn't him. It was our team, too. So, and they worked a lot harder for Josh. So good for Josh and good for our team.
Special teams good again. I mean, our penalty kill continues to just keep rolling.
Yeah, Damon Witten's doing a real nice job with the penalty killing. You know, that five-minute major they killed in the third period was huge. And, you know, sometimes, you know, you might give up a power play goal here or there, but there's certain instances in a game where you really need a penalty kill. And last night that five-minute major was one, and they did an excellent job. And then our power play kicked in a big goal, too. So we won the special teams battle last night, and that's always critical in having a chance to win games.
Good luck tonight, Coach.
Yeah, thanks, Dirk.